Okay. Right off the bat, it struck me that one of our greatest filmmakers of all time, perhaps my favorite filmmaker, began as a documentary photographer and then a documentary filmmaker before he turned to fiction. But the exhibit really shows how what is fiction and nonfiction, and there's a huge area where they come together. And it's the difference between what are facts and what is truth. And what are we on that eternal search for? I think the long game is that we are in search of the truth. You can see the same style, the same work, 10, 20, 30, 40 years after he takes these photographs. Look at just the way some iconic shots from his films that if you've seen them, you can't get them out of your head. The twin girls in The Shining. The war room, the situation room in Dr. Strangelove. Kirk Douglas, and he's going to reveal himself to save everyone else, and then everybody starts standing because the Romans want to know who's Spartacus, and they all start saying, "I am Spartacus, I am Spartacus, I am Spartacus." And just take a look at that. Look at how each of these shots are framed. You don't know whether to keep staring or to look away. It's so, because it's affecting your soul at that point. And now you've got to make a decision to engage or run away. And at the end of the exhibit is a 16-minute documentary film. It's his first film. It's called Day of the Fight, and he's going to follow this fighter, Walter Cartier, from the time he gets up in the morning until the fight that night. One of the most amazing things, as I was sitting there watching it, and it was the close of the day here at the museum, and I'm looking at my watch, and the film has run like 14 minutes already, almost 14 minutes, and I'm thinking, it's only a 60-minute film, and we're not even at the fight. Because you're thinking, it's a fight film, we're gonna see 3, 5, 10 rounds of the fight. His thought of Day of the Fight is about the day, not the fight. He gets to the fight, don't worry, you'll understand what happens. But the real point of what he's trying to show of the work, and this is a job, the work that's involved of an individual who's going to that night at 10 p.m. Get into a ring and box with somebody else. But it's not the boxing that's the story. He's the story, the work is the story. That day in New York City is the story. But he gave everybody a crystal ball there in 1951. And you can see, I think, now what was going to happen then after that.